A very good morning to teachers and all my friends. Today, I'm going to talk about the importance of volleyball. For me personally, I'm not really good at volleyball. In fact, I suck at it. But there's this strange power that attracts me and makes me curious to find out all the fun facts and benefits of volleyball to others. So let's get started. Volleyball, a dynamic and accelerating sport, offers a plethora of benefits that extend far beyond the confines of the court. From physical fitness to mental well-being, playing volleyball is a transformative experience that fosters personal growth, camaraderie, and a sense of belonging. In today's speech, we'll delve into the myriad advantages of playing volleyball and how it positively impacts individuals of all ages and backgrounds. First and foremost, physical health fitness. One of the most apparent benefits of playing volleyball is its contribution to physical fitness. The fast-paced nature of the game demands agility, speed, and endurance, thereby providing a comprehensive cardiovascular workout. From jumping to spiking to diving, volleyball engages multiple muscle groups including the legs, arms, core, and shoulders. As players continuously move around the court, they improve their balance, coordination, and reflexes, enhancing overall athletic performance. Moreover, volleyball promotes the strength development of the upper body through activities such as serving, blocking, and setting. Regular participation in the sport can lead to increased muscle tone, improved bone density, and enhanced flexibility. Additionally, the repetitive nature of volleyball movement enhances joint stability and reduces the risk of injury, making it an ideal sport for individuals of all fitness levels. Secondly, mental well-being benefits. In addition to its physical benefits, volleyball offers numerous advantages for mental well-being. The collaborative nature of the sport fosters teamwork, communication, and leadership skills as players work together to achieve a common objective. Through strategic planning, decision-making, and problem-solving, volleyball cultivates cognitive abilities that are transferable to various aspects of life, including academics, career, and interpersonal relationships. Other than that, social benefits. Volleyball serves a powerful catalyst for social interactions, fostering a sense of community, belonging, and friendship among players. Whether competing on a team or participating in a recreational league, volleyball provides opportunity for individuals to connect with each other who share their passion for the sport. Through shared experience, victories and setbacks, players forge deep bonds and create lasting memories that transcend the boundary on and off the court. Last but not least, personal growth benefits. Beyond its physical, mental and social benefits, playing volleyball fosters personal growth and self-development. The challenges and obstacles encountered on the court provides opportunity of resilience, perseverance, and grit. Whether facing a formidable opponent or overcoming a losing streak, players learn valuable lessons in resilience, determination, and sportsmanship that translates into success. Furthermore, volleyball instills essential life skills such as time management, discipline, and goal setting. Balancing academic or professional responsibility with athletic commitments requires players to prioritize tasks, manage their schedule efficiently, and stay organized. By honing these skills, volleyball players develop a strong work ethic and a sense of responsibility that serves them well in all aspects of life. In conclusion, playing volleyball offers a multitude of benefits that encompass physical fitness, mental well-being, social interaction, and personal growth, whether as a recreational pastime or a competitive pursuit. Volleyball has the power to transform life, enrich communities, and inspire individuals to reach their full potential. As we continue to explore the many advantages of playing volleyball, let us celebrate the sport's ability to unite people, promote healthy lifestyles, and cultivate lifelong relationships. Thank you.
Yang dihormati guru-guru dan rakan-rakan seperjuangan, salam sejahtera dan salam satu Malaysia. Saya Chua Kai Sin dari kelas 5 Bill Gates. Andai patah sayap Raja Wali, bertongkat jua saya kemari. Bukan kerana ingin bermimpi, tetapi untuk membawa anda semua menyelami tajuk pidato saya pada hari ini, iaitu Bahasa Jiwa Bangsa. Sebelum kaki mengorak langkah lebih jauh, izinkan saya mendefinisikan tajuk pidato saya. Bahasa, menurut Kamus Dewan, adalah sistem lambang bunyi suara yang dipakai sebagai alat perhubungan dalam satu kelompok manusia. Jiwa, nyawa atau roh. Manakala bangsa pula bermaksud kumpulan manusia dalam satu ikatan ketatanegaraan. Dalam konteks pidato saya, konsep bangsa dan bahasa secara total merujuk kepada bangsa Malaysia dan bahasa kebangsaan kita iaitu bahasa Melayu. Hadirin yang dihormati sekalian, mengapakah bahasa itu dikatakan jiwa atau roh bangsa? Apakah keistimewaan bahasa Melayu kita yang sekian lama diagung-agungkan seantero dunia? Marilah bersama-sama saya mengupas persoalan ini satu persatu melalui tiga komponen penting yang akan merungkaikan peranan bahasa Melayu ke arah memartabatkan negara di mata dunia. Hadirin sekalian, yang pertama, bahasa Melayu mencerminkan jati diri bangsa Malaysia. Jati diri atau identiti sesuatu bangsa merujuk kepada ciri-ciri yang membezakan sesuatu kumpulan manusia dengan kumpulan manusia lain. Menuturkan sebuah bahasa yang sama ialah antara ciri yang menentukan jati diri sesebuah bangsa. Tahukah anda, rakyat Switzerland menuturkan empat bahasa yang berlainan iaitu bahasa Perancis, Jerman, Itali dan Roman. Namun, di Malaysia, kita hanya mempunyai satu bahasa kebangsaan yang dituturkan oleh masyarakat pelbagai keturunan. Tuntasnya, realiti bahasa Melayu sebagai cermin jati diri bangsa Malaysia tak lapuk dek hujan, tak lekang dek panas. Hadirin sekalian, yang kedua, bahasa Melayu sebagai bahasa ilmu. Sehingga kini, bahasa Melayu berperanan sebagai bahasa sosial, bahasa ekonomi, bahasa pentadbiran dan bahasa peradaban moden. Bahasa kebangsaan juga telah berfungsi sebagai bahasa akademik yang lengkap. Oleh itu, tidak hairanlah jika bahasa Melayu kini sedang diajar dan dikaji di 108 buah pusat pengajian tinggi di serata dunia. Sebagai pewaris tinta para sarjana, sejuk hati dan mata memandang, apatah lagi telinga ini mendengar. Setiap bait kata yang dilafazkan oleh para peserta pertandingan pidato antarabangsa bahasa Melayu yang diadakan pada setiap tahun. Hadirin sekalian, yang ketiga, bahasa Melayu pemangkin perpaduan. Konsep perpaduan telah lama diterapkan dalam kalangan masyarakat Malaysia. Sehingga hari ini, perpaduan masih lagi menjadi agenda utama negara di bawah gagasan Satu Malaysia. Dengan bahasa yang sama, rakyat Malaysia yang terdiri daripada pelbagai kaum tetap bersatu padu, walaupun mempunyai latar belakang agama, adat resam dan budaya yang berbeza. Hadirin sekalian, sebelum saya menamatkan baik-baik bicara saya, ingin saya simpulkan bahawa bahasa Melayu bukan semata-mata untuk orang Melayu, tetapi untuk semua rakyat Malaysia. Bahasa adalah nadi penggerak untuk menzahirkan identiti sesuatu bangsa. Tiada kata secantik bahasa nak kucurahkan rasa. Tiada gambar seindah lukisan nak kutunjukkan perasaan. Tiada bahasa secantik puisi nak kucurahkan isi hati. Oleh itu, gunakanlah bahasa yang santun. Buktikan bahawa kita merupakan masyarakat yang bertamadun, kaya dengan berbudi bahasa dan memiliki minda kelas pertama. Setakat ini sahaja pidato saya pada hari ini. Sekian, terima kasih. Terima kasih.